can understand that the tensions and turmoils which were let loose in the European history, which they say, in fact, I was looking at the browsing through the internet about the kind of deaths that have taken place in the last 2 millennia. More than 100 crore people have been killed, and a very large number of deaths is why 99% of the killings have taken place because of the ideas, ideologies and philosophies which had emanated and got into power and position and influence from Europe. So it was a society of such unbearable tension, inner pain, that produced this philosophy. And don't think it produced only that philosophy. This philosophy was a reaction to another philosophy. That was the capitalism, which that is how these ideological evolutions were taking place simultaneously, one as the reaction to the other. And my friend Professor Varadarajan used to say that communism and capitalism are not opposites, but they are two sides of the same coin. In fact, it took me, this he told me 20 years back, when I was becoming a tres professor in economics. I began understanding the substance of what he was saying by analyzing what is the underlying philosophy of both. The underlying philosophy of communism and capitalism was one and the same. Both looked at the world only as a material phenomena, and both rejected the idea of God and divinity. Both concluded that human beings were just a bundle of wants and desires, and the only question is how to fulfill it. Capitalism would say, in fact, somebody put it so beautifully, I think Noam Chomsky, he said that at the time the Chernobyl blast took place in Russia, Chomsky said the only difference between capitalism and communism is communism will have Chernobyl at any cost, capitalism will have it only if it yields profit. That's all the difference. If there is profit, there is capitalism. Even if there is no profit, there is communism. That's the difference. Otherwise, in their assessment of human beings, their history, their philosophy, their interrelationship, their sensitivities and sensibilities, there is absolutely no difference between the two. The only thing is, capitalism knew how to live with the differences and allow people who die, who have different views, to die a peaceful death. It's a gas chamber. But communism will kill them. That's the difference. Now one has collapsed. And there is no doubt it has collapsed, though. You see, nothing collapses completely. You go and see all these Babylonian civilizations, there are still structures standing. So CPM will be there, CPA will be there. That doesn't mean the structures are there. So collapse has taken place. Even they do not probably say that the world is going to rise up as a communist power, proletarian unity. All this is gone. And the fundamental difference between the two is, one says there has to be individualism but collectivized under the state, where the state will disappear, ultimately all individuals will live happily, like our Krita Yuga. Communism began with Kali Yuga and tried to end up in Krita Yuga. A stateless society where everybody is happy, no policemen are needed, no prime minister is needed. The world doesn't need a government. This is the extent to which the theoretical exposition of communism took the world to and made the world believe. But we knew from our experience that we have moved away from Krita Yuga into Kali Yuga. You have to understand that the world is a tough world. So we made our people practical. If our people are in difficulties, they know they have to be in difficulties and they have to tackle these difficulties. But communism did the reverse. You need not have to be in difficulty. See the world we are projecting to you. See the consequence of it. the amount of death and destruction this ideology caused by blinding the world to believe that it is taking them to utopia on this earth.